Hey guys, welcome back to my channel Kanika Jain this side, and in this video we shall be making this mixed media canvas. So let's get started. So here I have taken a 6-inch canvas, and with the help of my Finnawear Art Basics white heavy gesso, I am priming the surface. Next, to add a textured layer, here I am using this Finnawear stencil in the design Wild Berries. And with the help of my silicone brush, I am giving a textured layer with my texture paste. If you want to know more about this silicone brush, do watch out our video number 49. The link is in description box, and you can see how you can use this silicone brush. As well, the link to all these craft supplies which I am going to use in this video, the link is in description box. You can check out the description box, and if you want to buy, you can directly buy those craft supplies from the link. And if you're new to our channel and watching our tutorial for the first time and have not yet subscribed to our channel, then do hit the subscribe button and turn on the bell notification so you never miss an update from us. So here I am nicely covering the base with the help of texture paste and giving a stenciled layer, and here you can see how beautiful the outcome has come out to be. Now I let it dry naturally, and then we'll move on to the next layer. That is, I have used the stars and moons mold, and as well I have used the cogs and wings mold from Prima, and using the Sakura clay I have taken out the impressions. Now I'll adhere all these impressions, so you can use your 3D gloss gel as well. Here, to start off, I'm adding some metal embellishments on the borders. Now I will be adding a layer, that is, I'll be adding these wings, as well as I have taken this lower lattice mold and I have taken out the impression and I have cut it with the help of scissor into different parts, and now I'll be adding it like this. And if you want to know that what all products can be used to take out impressions from the silicone molds, you can watch out our video number 50. The link is in description box, and you can know that what all products can be used to take out impressions from the silicone molds. Now I have taken up the star impression as well, and I'm adhering it onto my canvas onto some random places. Now I'm going to take my funnel tray, and I have these mini stones. These are the mini art stones by Prima, and I'm randomly sprinkling it over to the base. So onto the places where I have my glue, I have my liquid adhesive, they will get sticked. Now I'm taking this Finnawear sentiment stickers, and I'll be selecting some of them. Here I have this sentiment which says dream without fear, and I have some leftover from this impression, so I'm making it look like a frame or giving a border to my sentiment like this, and then again adding some stars. Now I'll let everything dry and then start coloring, but before that I am applying a coat of white heavy gesso again, as I have some metal embellishments and I want to prime them up, as well as I want to prime my clay embellishments. So I'll just apply a coat of gesso and then let everything dry, and then I'll start to color up. So to start coloring, here I have the first color. This is the Art Alchemy liquid acrylic from Finnabear in the shade Carmine. With the help of Mini Mister here, I am watering down onto the canvas and diluting the color with the water and then randomly spreading it out with the help of my brush. One way is to apply the color like this, the other is to directly apply the color onto your canvas and then sprinkle some water. You can use this liquid acrylics in any way. Like here I have applied the color onto my canvas and now misting some water and moving out my canvas so that the water gets sprinkled all over and the cover, and it covers my background fully with the color. Also, you can see with the help of just one shade, I am giving a little bit of monochromatic look to my canvas. So here you can see I am almost done coloring the base layer with the help of liquid acrylic, and don't forget to color the sides of the canvas as well, as it is important to color the sides of your project as well. Now I will just let it dry, and for the next layer here I have this Art Alchemy metallic color in the shade Hazelnut, and I am using my stenciling brush and I'll just do some dry brushing onto some random areas to give a little bit of vintage look, or you can see the effect of brown to my project. I hope you are enjoying this tutorial, so don't forget to hit the like button. So this acrylic paint will give a very contrasting look to my project, as it will add a little bit of depth as well. And here what I'm going to do is I have the metal embellishment, so here I'm covering it with the help of this same shade, that is the hazelnut shade, and it will give a very nice shimmery and metallic look to the embellishment. And now I'm just randomly adding the same color to some embellishments to give a very nice blended effect. Now I'm taking up this acrylic paint in the shade Gold Rush, and similarly I will be applying a coat, and I'll be just dry brushing it onto some areas. Like I'll be just highlighting with this shade. You can use your waxes as well. Later in this video you will see me using some waxes to highlight as well. Next, I am taking up this Art Alchemy Sparks in the shade Unicorn's Hair. The sparks add a little bit of more shimmer or glitter to my project, so onto some areas I'm just highlighting with the help of this Unicorn's Hair color, and now with the help of my dry, like I'm just giving a little bit of dry brushing using the same shade onto some random areas. Now with the help of same shade, I'm just giving a boundary, or you can say the borders, as it will give a very nice shimmery border look to my project. Now I have added 3D double-sided foam tape onto my sentiment and I have adhered this, and now with the help of my bone folder I am pressing it nicely so that it gets sticked. And now I had some leftover sparks color, so I'm just dry brushing. Now I am again using this Finnabear sentiment stickers, and I am taking out this dreamer, and I have added a layer of black cardstock on the base, and now I'll simply stick it out here. Now just for the finished look here, I am using Art Ingredients glass glitters in the shade Gold Rush. This is how the glass glitter looks like, and it will add an extra shimmer, and the final a look to my project. So I'm just adding my liquid adhesive randomly onto some areas. Now I'm going to simply sprinkle it out and take off the excess onto my funnel tray. And ta-da, we are done. So this is how the canvas looks like. This is the final outcome. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and you had a great time watching it. So see you soon. Until next time, till then, happy crafting. Bye bye.